Again, I don't think it was intuitively surprising that he didn't do well there. And I think that the bigger point is not that Romney didn't do well, but that Gingrich really struck out, and that Santorum now has this kind of head-to-head campaign with Romney. And I think that although Gingrich is saying he'll stay in the race all the way to Tampa, and his benefactor in Las Vegas, Mr. Adelson, may continue to give him some money, I think it's got to be pretty clear, even to sort of a low-information Republican voter, that Newt is not really a factor. And the former Newt voters are going to be migrating to other places, I think primarily to Santorum. That could change the dynamic of the race in an important way.
Bill, you were out with Santorum. He thinks he's the only alternative to Mitt Romney now, doesn't he?
He has pitched us this as a two-man race and has really struggled in how he's trying to push Newt Gingrich out. He keeps saying that, I didn't ask Newt Gingrich to run in the first place. I'm not going to be the one to ask him to get out. But his advisors quietly are trying to nudge Gingrich out,
and even not so quietly sometimes.
Well, it was interesting. I was with them on election night in Lafayette, Louisiana, and Alice Stewart, the campaign press secretary, when asked if it was time for Gingrich to exit, she said absolutely. Her boss, the communications director, Hogan Gidley, in a follow-up message says, no, we're not pushing him out. And it was just crossed wires there, trying to find the right pitch to give Gingrich an honorable exit.
Right. And why is that? Just to be nice to him? Or is it because they want every one of his voters they can possibly get, and they don't want to look like they're kind of dancing on his grave?
Yeah, they need, if Santorum is going to get the nomination, he needs every Newt voter to defect from Newt to him. He needs the conservative base of the party to rally around him, and he does not want to turn them off or anger them by being mean. It's the problem we saw in 2008 with the Clinton and Obama courting the Edwards voters. You don't disparage the candidate and then ask their strongest supporters to come to you.
Right. Michael, it helps Romney to keep Gingrich in the race, keep splitting the vote, or is there a way in which Gingrich sticking around? There's been a bit of a debate about this, where Gingrich sticking around for Mitt Romney, he keeps beating up on Romney, calling him a Massachusetts liberal. So even if Gingrich isn't doing much in the way of getting votes, he's beating up on Romney, and that's not good. Where do you come down on this?
Well, I come down on how Newt plays it. I mean, it depends on how hard he's hitting Romney. I think I'm inclined to think that it's helpful for Romney for him to stick around. I think it's really problematic if Santorum can rally the conservative base. It's mano a mano, showdown Armageddon. It's just muddier with Newt around. And I would add that, you know, if Newt is not coming at Romney with fresh attacks, new issues that he has to respond to, he's not driving the news, I think to some degree it kind of becomes white noise. If he's just sort of saying, you know, healthcare and he doesn't want a moon base and I do. I mean, at some point, I don't think it does that much damage. So if I'm Romney, I want him to stay.